Hello everyone, back with Raka again in Raktek Gaming. In this video, I will be showing you how to cast your Android screen to your PC, as well as controlling your Android directly from your PC, without having to spend money or rooting your phone. Now, I know that there are apps that allow you to do just that, with a graphical user interface and a straightforward usage, but they all have a downside, in that you will have to pay for the services. Some only mildly inconvenience you, like putting a watermark on your screen, but others will go as far as limiting your bandwidth or outright not allowing you to use wired connection at all, unless you pay them monthly for a premium account. Fortunately, there's a free and open source alternative to this. It's called scrcpy, or pronounced scrcpy. Although it doesn't have a graphical user interface, it offers you a wide range of tools for all your phone to PC needs, from screencasting, screen recording, and even cross-device clipboard. Screencopy can do all of that and more without any payment from you. All you need is an Android phone, a PC, and a USB cable for a smooth connection. You can download Screencopy from their GitHub repository, linked on the screen below and in the description. Before we start though, this installation guide will mostly be for Windows operating system, but it is also available for Linux and macOS. If you're not using Windows, you can follow the instruction provided on the respective documentation page, linked also in the description. Now, if this is your first time on GitHub, you can find the files on the releases section on the right side of the screen. Simply click on the latest version and scroll down until you see a bunch of files. Depending on which bit version your Windows are, you just need to click the zip file with the correct bit version to download it. Once you have finished downloading the file, just extract it with WinRAR or similar tools. The app comes pre-installed, so you can move the extracted folder anywhere and directly run it without problems. Before connecting your Android to your PC, you will first have to enable the developer option on your Android. Each manufacturer has a slightly different way to do it, but generally, you will have to tap your build number on the About Phone section a couple of times. For Xiaomi-based phones, you can go to the phone settings, open the About Phone menu at the top of the list, then press the MIUI version 7 times until you see the pop-up saying that the developer option is enabled. Once it is enabled, open the Additional Settings menu and scroll down until you find the Developer Options menu. If it isn't already enabled, enable the Developer option, then scroll down until you see USB debugging. When you enable USB debugging, you will be met with a security warning. But as long as you don't carelessly connect your phone to an unknown cable and device, it will be safe. And that's it! You don't need to download any additional app on your Android, and you can start casting your phone to your PC. If you also want to control your Android from your PC, you will have to also enable USB debugging security settings, but it is not required if you only want to cast your screen. Now you can start connecting your Android to your PC. First, connect your phone to your PC using a USB cable, and optionally enable file transfer when prompted. After that, open the folder where you extracted Screencopy, and open the scrcpy-console.bat file to directly start Screencopy. If the phone is properly connected, a window will start with your phone screen displayed in it. This will display whatever is displayed on your screen, including notifications and screen rotation, so be careful about it if you're showing it to other people. Congratulations! You are now able to cast your Android screen to your PC. If you have also enabled the security settings on your phone, you can simulate touch controls as well as keyboard input to your phone from the window. You can also copy-paste between the device by copying a text from one device and pasting it on another, as well as directly installing an APK file by dragging the file to the display window. The display output and input is minimal and unnoticeable, although the audio buffer is much more noticeable, similar to when using a Bluetooth earphone. Now, you may have noticed that the audio does not synchronize well with the display, such as when gaming or watching videos. Fortunately, you can control them with parameters. As explained in the beginning, scrcpy does not have a graphical user interface, meaning that you have to use a terminal if you want to change your settings. Before changing a setting, make sure to close all instances of scrcpy by directly closing the window. To change a setting, open the open_a_terminal_here.map file, and a console command window will show up. Starting a scrcpy instance always requires you to first type in scrcpy on the console command, which on its own will start scrcpy with default settings. To run scrcpy with other settings, you will have to add parameters after scrcpy. All of the available parameters can be read on the GitHub documentation page linked below and in the description, where you can read the various parameters on each category. Alternatively, you can read the parameters by typing in scrcpy --help on the console. Now, I know that there are a lot of available parameters that you can use, so I will be showing a few of them that might be used frequently. First is the buffer parameters, which help with synchronizing the display and audio. On the console, type in scrcpy, and then add the --display-buffer=parameter and the --audio-buffer=parameter. For the value, set both buffer with the same value. I recommend setting the value between 100 to 200 milliseconds to ensure a stable but quick buffer. You may have also noticed that when casting, while the phone audio is outputted on PC, it does not get outputted on the phone. This is not a bug, because the audio can only be outputted from one device. If you are gaming and require an instant output for both display and audio, I recommend to instead set the audio to be outputted from the phone, because unlike PC output, the audio output from the phone does not suffer from buffering. To do that, add the --no-audio parameter after scrcpy to disable audio casting to your PC. Next is the bitrate parameter, which controls the quality of your display. The bitrate parameter allows you to increase the bitrate between your phone and your PC, with a higher bitrate meaning higher quality and a lower bitrate meaning faster quality. To set the bitrate, simply add the -b parameter followed by the desired bitrate, such as 2M for 2 megabits per second. If you want to lock the screen to a certain orientation, you can do so with the --lock-video-orientation=parameter. This will lock the display to one of four orientations, with 0 value for portrait, 90 or 270 value for landscape, and 180 for upside-down portrait. Finally, one feature that might be useful is the screen recorder parameter, which allows you to record your phone screen and save it to your PC. This is especially useful if your phone doesn't natively support screen recording or if you're recording with a long duration. To record your screen, simply add the -r parameter followed with the desired name for the recording, such as file.mkv or file.mp4. The recording will be saved on the same folder where scrcpy is, unless specified before. Alternatively, if you only need to record the screen without casting it to the PC, you can add the --no-playback parameter to disable casting while still enabling recording. To stop recording, just stop the related display window or pressing Ctrl+C on the console. As well as the mouse and keyboard typing, scrcpy also support general gestures on a typical phone, such as pressing the home or back button or emulating screen rotation. There are a lot of shortcuts available, and you can see what each of them does by reading them on the shortcuts page on the documentation, link below and in the description. While a wired connection is highly recommended, scrcpy does allow you to connect your phone to your PC wirelessly as well. To do that, you will need to connect both your Android and your PC to the same network, with a 5 GHz or 6 GHz network recommended for smoother connection. Unfortunately, you cannot use your phone hotspot as the network, since your phone will not be considered part of the network. Interestingly, the most straightforward way to wirelessly connect your device still requires you to use a USB cable. But if you cannot use your cable, then you can follow the next alternate method. While your phone is connected via USB to your PC, start a console command with the same open the terminal here bat file. Then type in scrcpy as well as the --tcpip parameter before entering the command. This will automatically detect your phone's local IP address as well as starting the required connection. After a while, the connection will be completed, and once the display window is active, you can disconnect your phone from the USB cable. Alternatively, you can directly connect your phone from its local IP address without having to use a USB cable. To check your phone's local IP address, go to Wi-Fi settings and open up the information regarding the connected network. There will be a section about IP address with your local IPv6 and IPv4 address in it. Simply remember the numbers after the last dot of IPv4, as the first three parts will always be the same 192.168.1 local address. After that, open the console and type in scrcpy followed by the --tcpip equal parameter, with the value being 192.168.1, the number from your local IP address. After a while, the devices will be connected and a display window will open. And that is all for this guide. If you have any questions regarding scrcpy, you can ask them on the comment section and I will do my best to help you out. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to like the video so you can watch it again later. Or if you want to watch more videos about gaming, especially Genshin Impact or Project Sekai, you can subscribe to my channel so you won't miss new videos every week. That's all for today's video. Thank you for watching, and see you in my next videos.